10 seconds, 5 seconds, start. Sir, I rise to present the budget for the year 2004-2005. The budget has been formulated against the background of strong recovery in national income and agriculture and an equally impressive improvement in our balance of payments. These and other developments in the economy have been covered in detail in the economic survey presented to the House of a couple of days ago. I shall therefore be in brief reviewing the current economic situation. In order to fulfill our social commitments and protect jobs, government had to take over a large number of sick units and sustain them through injection of fresh resources. While some of them have turned the corner, a large number of them continue to incur losses. The time has come to undertake a careful review of the performance of sick units in the public sector with a view to reducing the drain on our resources. This the government proposes to do. Economic viability must be the principal test for the survival of an enterprise. Honorable members will recall that when our government took office in January 2000, an important task before us was to revitalize the planning process and to give a new thrust to the programs of development. I am happy to say that in the last 4 years, we have been able to achieve an unprecedented increase in the tempo of public investment. Within this aggregate, plans of individual states show a varied picture. Some states have managed their finances well. They have been able to raise additional resources and effectively utilize these to implement adequately seized plans, providing development and growth to their people. Unfortunately, some states, for reasons of their own, have used their resources for various other purposes. They have not invested their resources, including additional resources mobilized for development, and have also resorted to large overdrafts on the RBI. Unfortunately, despite these measures, some states continued to rely heavily on overdrafts even after March 2002. Their proposed deficits at the end of March 2004 would have harshly affected the size of their plans if these deficits were adjusted against next year's plan as per normal practice in considering the ways of overcoming this problem, I have found myself in a predicament. On the one hand, no finance minister of the country.